cross track here. Super excited about that. Was doing some trail riding, J-Day stuff, and obviously I'm a motocross guy. So today I'm at Hemant Motocross Park. It is October 9th, 2021. It's called Harvest Fest, the function that we're at. It's a two-day open practice. There's trails, quad riding, dirt bikes, mud bogging, side-by-sides, everything. I only explored the two motocross tracks. It's a big facility. It's in Minot, Maine, Hemant Motocross Park. Check it out. Last time I was here, I raced back in 2003, the first and last time. So I'm back a long time later, doing some motos with my buddies. This was wild. I was super excited. A lot of people here, a lot of things going on. It was like a big party. If I had known, if I come next year, I think they do it yearly. If I come next year, I'll camp out and do the 2 day weekend. It was $40 to ride today. I think it's 40 per day. And no classes, anything goes. So check this out. This track was called Hilltop. There's two tracks, so this is two for one special. Look at the ramps on the left. So this is Hilltop. You get on the track. It was a hard base track with a lot of jumps. This is the track I believe I raced. It was going the other rotation though. A lot of flat tracking. It was fun. Even though it was hard base, there's a lot of tabletops. This is my third moto on this video and the other video, but this is the Hilltop track, off camber, downhill, big downhill, flat landing jump here, left hander into a rhythm section. You can go left or right. I prefer the left one, doubling this. I could double out, but probably not gonna make the turn after that. I was struggling. I tried one time, almost overshot it. Nice right hand berm. This was all flat track, so I was not good at that, but I'm destined to be good at it. I'm trying and trying. Then you have this right hander that was another flat track based, hard base, flying up to the straightaway to a big double booter. I was not hitting it, but it didn't look like it was too bad if I went right here to the left. You just gotta commit. It's all hard base. This right hander uphill off camber, and then a mound left hander. We're just getting a look at the track, and this was a fun day. I wish I stayed the weekend. Coming into this right-hander to a straightaway, you flying my bike. You can hear I can probably get into fourth gear. I was only in third. Hit this mound, go to the left inside is what I was practicing today, focusing on that. Then this jump, I was seat bouncing this, barely making it. Then this left-hander was like a sand section to a sweet tabletop. You could do all your funny tricks and stuff off if you wanted. To the right hander to this mound, and this is where I entered the track. So that was one lap at the Hilltop track, and someone went down here, so they had to go slow for a couple laps. I apologize. I think they got knocked out. They were all right. They had plenty of help, but that kind of sucks, especially when people are riding around you after you're hurt. But so we're going along back to this event. It was awesome. I'm definitely gonna do it next year if the weather holds up. It was an experience. I've done so many different things this year that I don't normally do, so I'm just enjoying it, going with the flow. One thing I noticed from riding J-Days and then get back on the motocross track, I wasn't charging like I typically would be. But anyway, it's not a big deal. Just you get it back and get your head back in the game. Charge mode and go after it. But so I just wanted you guys to see this track, view of the track, and see what line options you have. I went outside here, inside, outside, whatever. It's a hard base track. I got video right after this one of the Sawmill track, which is like a bigger, they call it their national style size track. So be sure to stay tuned, check that out. This is like a two for one special. You get two tracks in one day. The schedule was wild. It was 20 minutes on this track, and then you had like 10 minutes rested if you wanted, go to the other track and do 30 minutes there. And it went like that. It was timed perfect. Like every other track you could go, because they had different classes, like big bikes, little bikes, quads. On this track, quads were allowed. On the other track, quads were not. Side-by-sides were allowed on this track as well. But yeah, so it just was a sweet schedule, back and forth. I never rode that much in my life, back and forth, like without waiting. It was dope. But stay tuned, like and subscribe the channel. I'm gonna cut this video short so you can see the other track in a second. Comment, definitely keep me motivated if you comment. It helps me assure that I wanna keep doing these videos and let you all see the tracks and the fun that I'm having. All right, we'll catch you in a few minutes. Back, still in Minot, Maine, at the Harvest Fest, Hemmons Motocross Park, October 9th, 2021. We're gonna go to the national caliber track, they call it. It's a Sawmill. Sawmill is the name of the track. It's this big, like, up and down elevation change track, hard packed. I want to say it's hard packed, but we'll do a couple laps. I'll give you a vision of, or I'll talk of what I'm seeing. I'm just gonna come in here and do like a start and practice for like J days or whatever. What do you call it? Like a dead start or whatever. Start the engine and take off. But yep, here we go, Sawmill. Here's the starting gate. And it's a high speed track, hard dirt, soil, good soil. And this is my third moto, so it got all ruddy with like a lot of big holes in the ruts. I don't know what you call that. Like, you know, I call them wheel denting holes. They kill your wheels, but in the back. But here's the first start to the left hander. It was kind of like a flat track rut. style. You get going fast on this track. A lot of braking bumps here. Going inside, trying to follow the ruts. Going up this little hill to the left-hander. Ruts, little mound here. Then a left-hander. I know I wasn't charging this lap. I finally was doing this. If you watch a little longer, I'm doing that table, taking this right. You can like triple this into the rhythm section, that little table, and then this rhythm section, flying around here in third gear. Left-hander was like dark soil, real like choppy right here. You can see it's like a stand-up kind of a rut, real long. I hate these, but going up to this single right-hander, then it's like a jumpy tabletop section. You got this one to this high speed, back section one into sand. So it was pretty dope. A lot of braking bumps here, washboard effect into the sand. Jump down this little area, fly to this tabletop. You just kind of like hover over that one, and then you gotta jump this one. You can overshoot it and miss the turn. I was trying to line up that inside line. Then I was wide open to seat bounce this, and damn, I OJ'd it. I landed flat, so I couldn't hit this to the top. But taking this right, you had some rut options. This track was awesome too. Taking this left, right, switch back into this little rhythm section. There was that clay looking soil that would swap your bars if you landed wrong. I'm going the inside here, taking this flat track left. Still trying to feel out all the jumps. You know, I have never been to this track, so it's a first day at the track. Those rollers, then this awesome tabletop. And I think we're gonna go left. I thought that was the start. That's not the start. Then you're hitting this one, taking this inside. The outside was too far out there. It was real rutted, like deep soil, hard base. Take this right, inside or outside lines. Take this left, up over this little table. I was clearing that after a while. And then down the straightaway, this track was long. This nice table, going down this hill, third gear wide open if you can. Doing this 90 here. This was like a Southwick kind of section, like uphill, skip jump this mound, land in some soft soil, and just hammer down, go full speed. Take this left, those two lines on the inside here, that was pretty cool. Down the hill now. This track had a lot of different options. Taking the inside here, these long ruts down there. I was going inside to the mound instead of going wide, and then land here, another like Southwick style hill, sand. Then fly up to this flat landing, double, whatever, a step up. And then there's the start to the right. So now we're at the lap two. Like this track, I had more fun on the little one because it was like whippy and like flat, you know, flat tracking. I'm not good at that, but I was like testing my tires. It's fun. It was a short lap. This was a long lap. This was fun too, but a lot of different stuff here. The laps are long. See here, I'm hitting that jump now. But yeah, no, it was super good. You gotta check this place out if you've never been. Man, it was just like a motocross dream or any off-road vehicle. There was Jeeps here, there was side-by-sides, there was quads, there was anything goes. It was wild. There's no, like, I mean, you had to wait for classes per bike size. It was big bikes, little bikes, ATVs, or side-by-sides go together. But in the woods, I guess I didn't go in the woods, but you can like ride some loops they have. There's mud bog trails for you Jeep people and quads. It was sick. A lot of people here. I would definitely get here early. I got here at 10 a.m. and we left at like, I want to say 3. I was smoked. I couldn't ride anymore. It was wild. So here's this jump. I was seat bouncing this, landing right, and then trying to clear the step up. It was stretching it out super hard. This track was fun. They were both fun. I never rode so much in one outing at a time, like back to back to back. I think I put like an hour and a half on my bike. It was wild. But yeah, check out Hemmons Motocross Park. I don't know if they do a lot of practice here. I should look into this before I do the videos, but you all know I'm just winging it. Yeah, you're just on board getting a view of the track. I'm trying to just show you what the track is like so you have something to like look forward to when you get there. And you can have it in your head, unlike me and figuring it out on the fly. But anyway, that's about it. Like, subscribe to the channel. like I keep saying, comment. You can joke on the comments, do some funny stuff if you'd like. Keeps me interested, motivated to continue to do videos. But yeah, anyway, thanks again for watching, and continue to watch if you'd like. We'll catch you at the next one. Later.